finally at the beaches of Zanzibar, and today I will give you some information regarding the arrival and immigration here in Tanzania, because I find that some YouTubers and bloggers are giving incorrect, or let's say incomplete, information, so that leads to confusion. This is what happened to me. I'm not saying that they are giving misleading information or inaccurate information, but you know, they miss out on some stuff, so which had me to do special research. So I wanna come straight to the point, immigration, and I give you the latest update first. What I just found out from a from another expat who is living here, he told me this thing. So you need a PCR test to when you arrive in Tanzania. Yes, you do need now a PCR test when you arrive in Tanzania. That is the latest news and update. You know, this is one of the reasons why I came here, because I did not need a PCR test, but I will come to this later in a second. And many other people are traveling to Zanzibar, or travel to Zanzibar or Tanzania, because the country did not require a PCR test, you know, and all the other corona nonsense is basically not happening here. That's why people are traveling here, and that's why the country was recommended to me, was recommended to travel to Tanzania and Zanzibar, and so I did. Yes, but now you need a PCR test. But anyway, in order to get here, you need to fly an airline. You need to fly with an airplane, and I think all of these airlines now require a PCR test anyway. So that's unfortunate. I know I'm not a fan of PCR test at all. So here's my story. I flew actually from Egypt, so I had to do a PCR test in Egypt. I tried to find an airline which does not require a PCR test to get here to Tanzania, but all these airlines like Egypt Air and Emirates, they require a PCR test when you exit Egypt. I read some information before that Egypt Air is not requiring a PCR test, and also Emirates. That was information given by other travelers, but now probably they changed the rules. You need a PCR test. So I had to make a PCR test, which I didn't like, and it was very expensive. Also, I paid $120. But the flight was straightforward. Emirates Airlines. I flew from Cairo to Dubai, then I changed plane, and the plane from Dubai to Tanzania to Dar es Salaam was basically empty. That was a very comfortable flight. You still had to wear a mask on board. I don't also get this, because all the passengers are tested negative, right? So why the hell we had to wear face masks? But this is a topic for a different video. Anyway, we arrived in Tanzania, and the airport is nice. It's not too big, but it's modern. People are very friendly. What I noticed is that airport staff did wear masks. All of them wear masks, or let's say 80%. And we had to pass a health check counter. Yeah, so in the airplane I was filling out an arrival card. They are handing out the arrival cards during the flight. You fill it out. It's a normal procedure like with any other country. And then the health declaration, they did not hand it out on the plane. So the health declaration you have to, or we had to fill out at the airport. There's a counter, you can fill these forms out. They're lying there. You grab one, make sure you have a pen handy, and then you fill it out. This is one sheet paper, very simple things. They basically, what they want to know, where have you spent the past 21 days, in which country. What they are very particular with is a yellow fever, and I did my research on this, as I want to share this with you. Make sure that you are either yellow fever vaccinated, I don't know, or you are not, you did not spend the past 21 days in a yellow fever vaccinated region or country. Because if you did, then, and you're not vaccinated, they do not let you into the country, as far as I know. You can do your own research again, but this is the latest research what I found out. Before, right before me, there were two Chinese guys which were passing the health check counter, and the lady asked them for their like yellow fever vaccination proof or what, I don't know what, and they had to show their vaccination booklet, yeah, the Chinese vaccination booklet. So I don't know where these Chinese people traveled before, if they came from in the yellow fever infected region, I don't know, but they had to show their, it was a, like a, it looked like a vaccination passport, it looks scary. And then the lady, the Tanzanian lady, health check authority, let the guys pass. With me there was no issue because I did not visit any yellow fever infected region before entering Tanzania, and I also marked that down on the health declaration, so that she just checked it and let me pass. Once I passed the health check, I went then to the visa on arrival station, which is not called visa on arrival but emergency visa, yeah, so don't get confused when you read emergency visa. This is the visa on arrival. There was one officer who asked me straight away what I'm doing here in Tanzania. I said I'm here for holiday, no issue. He passed me, he let me pass to the first counter. So the first, when you reach the first counter of the visa, the emergency visa, this is the counter where they take your passport, and then entering all your passport details into the system, that might take 5 to 10 minutes depending on how much traffic there is. After that, after they put all the information to the system, they return your passport back to you. Then you approach the counter number two, where you actually pay the visa fee of $50, so make sure you have $50 handy, ready cash. I don't know about other currencies, so I just tell you what I learned, what I was told by other travelers. Just make sure you have $50 in cash. As far as I know, they can change. Yeah, when you pay with a $100 bill, don't worry, they have a change. I don't know how it is if you want to change, pay with a euro or British pound or Canadian dollars. I don't know. Don't risk it. Just bring the $50 in cash. Once you paid it, then you will get your payment slip and your passport, and then you actually approach counter number three, which is the actual counter where you show your passport and you get your CHOP. Yeah, I forgot to mention that they also check the temperature with a small electronic pistol, so your temperature is being checked also, of course, but that shouldn't be an issue. Yeah, and once they CHOP your passport, you receive a 90-day visa CHOP. At least for me, I'm from Germany, and a lot of mosquitoes here. So I'm from Germany. German travelers receive a 90-day visa CHOP without any issues. And as far as I know, Indonesian passport holders also would receive a 90-day visa on arrival. You need to check your nationality, your country, of course, and find out about the different visa requirements. I cannot go into detail here with this. So this is the basic procedure, straightforward. It was not busy at the airport. We were the only plane arriving at the time with a handful of people, maybe 50 or 60 people. The most of them had visas, so and a handful of Chinese businessmen and me, we had to apply for visa on arrival. So the whole procedure took me probably 15 minutes, okay? Straightforward, no issues, no trouble. The only trouble starts once you picked up your luggage and you enter the arrival hall, because then you will be attacked of many people who will try to sell you something, offering you taxi rides and so many different things. But this is a topic for another video. So I hope I could give you clear, straightforward and concise information about the arrival in Tanzania, where you now unfortunately need also a PCR test in order to enter the country. So if you do not have a PCR test, then they will not allow you to enter. This is the information I have received from a guy who is also living here. He shared this information with me. He is an expatriate from South America, and this latest news came out on 2 days ago, May 4th. So this came into effect on May 4th. Just 2 days ago. So please do your research, double check my information I'm giving here again, and let me know. Other than that, let me know in the comment section if I forgot something. I hope not. Yeah, if you have any questions, let me know. I will answer everything. And then, yeah, wishing you a happy day, and see you in the next video. Take care. Bye bye.